us in the assessment team, like maybe we can go for each station, then you can explain what is happening, what is the assessment stage, and what we need usually get and what we need to prepare in the...
So from my own experience, the assessment stage is just being able to carry out admission on a patient. So being able to find out the cues of a patient, you know, most times when they are being brought into the hospital, you just need to get, now in real life, you need to get a lot of information, you need to feel everything. But with regards to the exam, you've been given details about this patient.
Yes.
They only want to see your skill on taking vital signs and asking questions related to the client's information they've given you already.
Mm-hmm.
So they want to see your judgment on how you're able to put together questions that will lead to planning the care for your patients.
Okay.
So for instance, I'll give an example. Like for my case, I got the MUSC form. Assess the nutritional status of a client.
Yeah.
Of a patient.
Mm-hmm.
It's to assess the nutritional, it's about the client's diet.
Yeah.
And then basically the nutritional level. So with that, because it gives information of the weight.
Yeah.
The BMI.
Yeah.
And how well the patient the client is eating. So with that, for instance, you know, they're giving you like a background of this patient and other things that are related to that. You, for instance, after seeing that kind of muscle, which is you feel that they filled it out for you already. You just need to like sign it and add it up. Okay. Now when you sign it and add it up, always sign. Documentation is very important. Mm. I will say this again. Everything you do, documentation is very important. Your signature, your dates, very important.
Yeah.
So after doing that, you have to also know ahead. Once you get in the assessment plan, while asking the patient different questions, you also have to, that point in time where they give you 5 minutes to read the case notes, you must have had an idea of what your problem is, your nursing problem will be to solve in the planning.
Okay.
So when I saw the muscle, I was already thinking already that, okay, this patient might be malnourished, might be at risk for malnutrition.
Okay.
So that was one of my problems. So that was one of my problems for the patient, malnutrition, at risk for malnutrition.
Yes. Yeah.
And they also said that this patient smokes.
Okay.
So the thing is, they expect you to meet activities of daily living.
Yeah.
And also to ask questions related to this client. So in that very client I had, they said something about her eating so much crepes and other stuff. So what I did was, after looking at the documentation, the thing is, once you go to the client, you do all the things, you know, check for safety and all that, and then you inform the client that you're going to take their vital signs. So with the fact that there was COVID, you're not allowed to do anything. You just say what you do when you do it. So what you're going to do instead. So basically, collecting data. After collecting data, then start asking. Always, when you collect your data for your vital signs, quickly just document your vital signs immediately and sign.
Okay.
And then you can go back to the client and ask the client all that questions.
Okay.
So for me, they also said she was partially blind. So I asked her, how does she walk around the home?
Okay.
You know, they said she uses a stick. Oh, so in my head, and my second problem is already that this woman lady or this man, whoever, is at risk for fall.
Okay. Oh, risk of fall, the second plan would be.
She's partially blind?
Yes.
So after treating the malnutrition problem, I also have to treat that problem of daily living as well, which is not able to get herself around the house properly because she's partially blind. So we also make sure that the house is properly lit.
Mm-hmm.
You know, these are things you do because it was a community setting for this one I got.
Okay.
Yeah, for instance. So basically, assessment, you just take all your cues, ask the patient relevant questions, and you need to be tap, tap, tap. That's important because if you have to do a proper assessment in the real life, in the world, it's going to take more than 15 minutes.
Yes, that's true. So what I understand,
with this exam condition, you just need to pick out what is necessary so that you can be able to plan.
Okay. What I understand is that in assessment stage, you will get a case note, half an hour or something, 10 minutes to read?
5 minutes to read.
So 5 minutes to read, then that time you will go through all the patient details. Then you go into the assessment station, then you will get a dummy, right? Then you just verbalize it. You don't really need to do anything.
Yes. Isn't it? Yes.
So the same thing, you have to verbalize everything. Then examiner will give you the sheet for BP is this and temperature is this.
The vital signs.
So then you need to record it. Then after that, you ask the patient their cues, like what we have to do for them.
Related
to the case notes. Okay. Usually, what type of things we get usually is, so you got a blind patient with malnutrition. You have to do must as well in the time, isn't it?
Yes. So they gave me two forms. They gave me the must form and also gave me a community. Maybe over time you can show them on the disability. They also gave me a community vital signs form.
Okay.
So not the new score.
Okay, community vital forms. That maybe.
Yes, I have a copy. I could scan it to you. So
okay.
Maybe you can.
Yeah,
use
I
that.
Can show that. Okay.
Or take a nice picture with that. Yeah.
Yeah, then that will show. So that is need to be filled. So before that, we used to fill the vital signs, the new score, we would say.
The new score, because I had a community setting, that's why I was giving that one. The new score is given for those who have a hospital scenario.
Okay, so the different scenario will get hospital scenarios. What are the hospital scenarios we will get in the assessment station?
So the hospital scenarios you can get, for instance, cardiac heart failure.
Oh,
CCF?
Okay.
Yeah, ectopic pregnancy, I think,
Oh my God, we got it because ectopic pregnancy,
I think that's more for midwives, to be honest.
Yeah.
But some people got it. I know somebody who wrote somewhere.
Okay.
Got similar, so.
Okay, so that can be, okay.
Yeah, and then I think the chest pain, so the patient with respiratory problem.
Okay, so what does
those
are
hospital
is your
scenario? Respiratory problem, heart problem. Those are hospital scenarios.
Okay.
I think there's one I'm missing out. Yeah, the GCS, the one that needs the GCS. Glaucoma skill.
What is
that's
that?
The head trauma.
Okay, head trauma. Okay.
Or head injury.
Yeah, head injury. Okay. So these are the main things we'll get it in the assessment station.
Yeah.
That station
yeah.
would be 10 to 12 minutes or 15 minutes.
So for me, my assessment was 12 minutes because this COVID period they reduced it because they said you don't have to do the vital signs on the patient anymore because you're verbalizing it. They said previously it used to be
When I had a real patient and we had to talk to the patient and that kind of thing. So anyway, that's a good thing. Then after that, what do you need to do?